Hello. In the previous tutorial, we have inserted a random distribution of plants inside an area, but they are individual plants. We will do the same, but using a forest component. So under the Lands tab, we find this forest component that will let us do a similar thing. So first, we need to input here the curve, the boundary curve, that we already have from the last exercise. And we have here some additional options for the forest object. I will just hide this component, doing middle click with the mouse and choosing this icon to hide the preview of these trees. Now, and I will do the same with the points of the initial distribution. Now, we will place here a forest options component that will let us define the features of this forest. So we connect this here, and for example, for the number of plants, we can connect the same number that we had used for the individual plants. And we can also use the same plant options that we have used for the individual plants. Now, if we bake this forest, we go to Solution and Bake Selected, we will get a forest object that we can further edit in Rhino.